I'm Thomas, and I'm a sex researcher. The divorce rate in the US is estimated to be somewhere between 40 and 50%, and one of the top reasons being infidelity. Cheating in relationships comes up a lot in both sex advice columns and podcasts, and depending on the advice that you're listening to, they're either going to likely tell you that you have to tell your partner absolutely 100%, or they're going to tell you that maybe you don't have to tell your partner. However, there is one piece of advice that I've never heard said or read in any advice column, and I kind of think it's the perfect solution. That one thing I suggest, drumroll please, talk about cheating before cheating happens. However, talking about cheating doesn't mean just saying, if you cheat, I'll f***ing kill you, or if you ever cheat on me, we're done. Cheating happens, breakups happen, and although these can be emotionally painful, the pain eventually goes away. However, HIV doesn't, and neither do some STIs. If you or your partner cheated, wouldn't you at least want to know that your health was protected?
Step 1. Establish a sexual agreement.
A sexual agreement consists of an explicit conversation about what the rules are of the relationship that everyone in the relationship can agree upon. Some couples are entirely monogamous, meaning they only have sex with each other. Some are entirely open, meaning they allow for sex outside of the relationship, but most of the couples that I work with are somewhere in the middle. Some might allow for sex with other people, but only when everyone in the relationship is present, or it's okay if they're out of town, or if it's only once, or never with an ex, or not with a friend, or only if it's someone from the past.
Step 2. Agree on the details.
Additionally, couples can also have agreements about the type of sex that is allowed outside of the relationship. For example, no spending the night, no kissing, only oral, any sex but only with condoms. The point being, people have all different types of agreements. Of course, that is when there is an agreement. Not all couples have had a discussion about their sexual agreement, and a lot of the time it's just assumed that they're monogamous by default. I can't even tell you the amount of times I've had someone in a relationship look to someone else and say, "Wait, you do that? I just assumed you didn't."
Step 3. Plan for how to handle a mistake.
Sometimes when our emotions are high, we respond in ways that maybe we look back on and wish we hadn't. If you already have a plan for how you would respond, you can enact that instead of just going on what your emotions say in the moment. So let's assume that someone did step outside of the sexual agreement of the relationship. Would you want to know? How much would you want to know? And how would you want to be told? For example, "No, I don't want to know, unless you have feelings for them, unless you don't use a condom, if I could get an STI, if it's someone I know." When it comes to how people like to be told, sometimes people say in person or over the phone, sometimes even via text message. When I ask how they would handle it, most people say they would sit down and discuss it. They would talk about the health risk, what needs to be taken care of in terms of any testing that might need to be done, and they would talk about what it means for their relationship. And this is a very important part of it. If you tell your partner that I'd kill you, or if you cheat, we're done, that doesn't mean that they won't cheat. That doesn't mean that they won't make a mistake, but it surely means that they will be less likely to tell you if they make a mistake. And that could put your health at risk. And discussing it isn't going to make it happen or not happen. In fact, I don't think not talking about cheating is going to make cheating not happen. So why would talking about cheating make cheating happen? Kind of think of it like a fire drill. You make a plan when there's not a fire, because when there is a fire, you're gonna react differently and you're not gonna know how to respond. Sometimes you go into panic mode. The same thing could happen with cheating. What you're actually doing is protecting yourself so that if something were to happen, you'd be able to still take care of your sexual health, instead of just having them hide it from you out of fear.
Step 4. Trust your agreement.
That's the one piece of advice. If you're in a relationship, talk to your partner about cheating before cheating happens. That's what I've got for you for now. But don't worry, I have a ton of content coming up. Everything's in production and I can't wait to share it with you. Go ahead and click that subscribe button so you don't miss out. In the meantime, follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and don't forget to send me your questions to thomastalksabout@gmail.com. I'm happy to answer as many things as I can about sex, love, relationships. We'll see what I can do. Until next time.